You're invited to this online healing retreat, which is a journey into the ancient mysteries of our world, including Lemuria, Atlantis, and other sacred sites. Ancient site researcher Brian Forster shares with us his images captured during the research of his many books.
The locations that I frequent in Peru, especially around Cusco and around Lake Titicaca, there are definitely places there which we are amassing evidence for the fact, like not the idea, but the fact that high technology existed thousands of years ago, and that the stone monuments are the remainder and reminder of an earlier people who were not just Lemurian, they were global in nature. Major connections in terms of proof of ancient technology are in Egypt and Peru, Bolivia.
Brian will share the story of the golden sun disk of Lemuria, which was taken with the Lemurian colonists to Peru.
There was a temple inside the Coricancha, which was the sun temple, sheeted completely in gold, and that was the first building that the Spanish gutted of its gold and destroyed. They literally tore it down to the foundation. There's no sign of it left anymore. The other temples are still there, the moon temple, temple of the rainbow, temple of lightning, but the sun temple was obliterated. But on the wall of that, there was a huge shield made out of either gold or another form of gold, and it was massive in size. The Spanish never actually got it because it was secreted away to Lake Titicaca and has been in hiding there ever since, because it was supposedly a gift from the people of Lemuria, or the one of the last remaining large ceremonial items that was able to be taken from there before that place was, you know, destroyed. I've heard from a lot of different people in and around Cusco that this giant sun disk did exist, and it still does. It's in safekeeping.
Synchronicity then led him to study a most fascinating subject of the elongated skull people, the focus of one of his upcoming books.
The first place I saw the skulls was in the little museum at the Coricancha, where the giant sun disk was supposed to have once been housed. And then I drew connections between the skulls there and those at Tiwanaku and Pumapunku in Bolivia. And my wife and I just happened to be traveling back from Chile about a year ago, and we stopped in this little seaside town called Paracas, and there was a museum, and in the museum there was one of these skulls again. I immediately became fascinated with that. The museum director said he had some more at home, and so I suggested that he bring them and put them in the museum, which he has done. And now I'm the assistant director of that museum, and we have 33 elongated skulls. I'm studying the ancient Paracas culture as well as medically through medical people, the skulls themselves, to see in what ways they're similar and in what ways they're different from both human beings of the same time period and present day humans. And it's getting incredibly intriguing. What I'm looking at now is connecting the megalithic sites of Peru and Bolivia with the elongated skull people. The more and more I look, the more and more I'm finding connections between the two. It seems like the skulls that we've been finding are the descendants of whoever the ancient megalithic builders were, this very mysterious people with amazing abilities to work stone.
Register today and join us on this visual journey to the world's ancient sacred sites with Brian Forster.